All right, back for round two. This hand's actually very close to being a keep. If we draw any land in two draw steps, we're pretty good to go. And this hand just like beats a lot of decks. I'm gonna mulligan it just because our deck's very good, but I like that hand. I actually think it was good. This hand is better, to be fair. We have turn three, Sorin or Solemn. The Huntmaster of our deck, if you will, and the Solemn of our deck. Because he's always the same. Ooh, we would not have beat a mono red player before. Glad we mulliganed. This hand's actually pretty good against mono red just because we have Sorin, which the life gain could be very relevant. Oh, he's got Stormblood Berserker, though. It's not good for us. Ooh, that's a good draw. That is a good draw. And a Phoenix. All right, we're doing pretty good here. We're at 16. I hope we just cast another Stormblood Berserker. Spikeshot Elder, sure. All right, let's get rid of these punks. All right, now I can reasonably drop a Sorin here. Start getting my life gain on. Life gain, what's to do? He's incinerating me. Okay, so he either has a plan for this lifelinker or he just doesn't care. Guess I'm okay with either of those scenarios. Best. Okay, he has Gutshot, sure. And then Chandra's Phoenix. Brimstone Volley. Okay. So Sorin's down, but we did gain six life in the process and a turn. So I can't complain all that much. Let's go get our second swamp. So he's got two cards in hand. We're at 12, and it looks like his cards are bad, which is good for us. Grab that. Play this. Play this. All right, drawing any specialty land, specifically Vault, would be insane. Drawing any fat spell would be very good. I am not going to play this sphere. I can't imagine a sequence where I need it. All right, well, we might just kill him with Solemns. Apparently, he's got all lands in hand. All right, he drew something good. Shrine. It's a little late for the shrine. Little late. And that's a Primeval Titan. So we have Vault and Gavney Township coming up. Not that it matters because he's eight. He's gonna have to kill one of these Solemns here pretty soon. It's possible he kills me here, but he's gotta do it right now. And I think he's gonna kill a Solemn. All right, sure. Yes, I would. Ooh. Can I cast two Titans? I think I can. Maybe I'm one short. Of course, I was like, I can't fathom a scenario where I need to. And I'm one short. But that's okay. Even if he has, Traitor's Blood main deck, which seems unlikely. I still think we win this game. Take six plus whatever this can deal, so three. That's nine. He's Volt charging, okay, so we're at nine. I don't know what he can draw, but I'm a little scared. All right, got there. Mono red defeated. Luckily, we have these two timely reinforcements in our sideboard, which should be nice here. Two Oblivion Rings come in. Celestial Purge comes in. Naturalize could come in, but I don't really want to bring it in. Day of Judgment could also come in, as could other things. But currently, this is what I'm bringing in. Sorin obviously stays. I kind of wish I had the other Sorin in my sideboard, but I don't. This is a matchup where I think Primeval Titan is slightly better just because he grabs Vault, but Grave Titan ends the game so much faster. I think I'm still going to cut Primeval Titan. He's only good against control decks, really. And he's, like, always good in the main deck, too, I guess. How do I feel about Garrick? I'm not a huge fan. Alright, let's cut Garrick. And then let's cut a Sphere, because he could bring an Artifact Hate. And do I want to bring in Naturalizes? I don't think so. Do I want to bring a Curse? I don't think so. Day of Judgment, I probably do want to bring in, though. Let's bring that in and take out... Actually, we have four Oblivion Rings, Purge, two Gopher Throats. I guess I could cut a Gopher Throat for it. I don't even know if that's right. But I'm going to try it. Alright, let's give this a shot. Woo!